the sacred nature of water. For me, it's really a change in mindset, and once it happens, it's really, you know, it sounds corny, but you really revere water. And I actually don't like the thought of it in a plastic bottle anymore. It's not just what I know about what it does and the privatization and the pollution. I don't like it encapsulated in fossil fuels and chemicals, because that's what plastic is. And so you really get a different, you're just like, it's bad, that's not nice for the water. The last thing I should say that we are really working on is this notion beyond public trust. Public trust, and Vermont, I work with the folks that they, legislators in Vermont. Vermont has a lot of groundwater, like Ontario. And they have all these bottled water companies and others coming in and just pumping it up and taking it away. They have no law. 2 years ago, they unanimously adopted a law, all of the Democrats and all of the Republicans together, that said their water is the public trust. And it's priority use, and this is what we have to do. It's priority use is water in watersheds, water, so protection of the water itself, the equitable access to people, and sustainable local food production. Those are the priorities. And for any commercial use, you have to apply, you have to get a permit, and they can control it. So this is a really good way. We need to be, I didn't even say this, we haven't even mapped our groundwater in Canada. We have no idea what our sustainability is. So that's another huge piece of what we have to do collectively. So, you know, but it's that consciousness, I think, that is so important. And beyond the access to it, then does the water itself have rights? And Ecuador, I know we've got to stop. Ecuador has become the first country in the world to pass legislation that says that the water has rights and nature has rights, and that aside from all of its use to us humans, it has the right to exist and be healthy in its natural environment. And I think that's the next step of where we're going. A great book called Wild Law by a guy named Cormac Cullinan from South Africa, Wild Law. So that's our next step, is beyond us, and it's hard to think beyond us because we're pretty us-centered, what rights do the earth have? When you look at that legislation in the U.S., the Supreme Court just confirmed that corporations are legal persons, and none of the animals in our world have that kind of status, something's wrong. And that's a challenge for you guys in your future. It will take the rest of our lives to do this, but what else have you got to do? Thank you.
Without a doubt, from the bottom of my heart and everyone else here, I'd like to thank Maude for giving us more reason to continue doing what we're doing.
Oh, yes.
Thank you very much. Now, we're going to have one announcement, and then I am going to arbitrarily, on behalf of everybody here, decide that the next session is going to start at 1:15, and we're going to go to the next workshop that's going to go.